I do a lot of digging and a lot of searching for stuff that will help out the DaVinci Resolve community, because I truly believe that DaVinci Resolve is one of the best programs to be made. And I want to wholeheartedly just help you guys as much as I can. If there's an effect that you guys want to make, I try my hardest to help you guys with that. These effects that came out that I found out about are not possible. This is like above my level of stuff that I can create, you know? And there's just no way I can get my hands on it. And that really, really pisses me off. So I'm going to go over a lot of the scripts and macros that I found that we may never have our hands on. Okay, so the first thing, and this breaks my heart, is the Newton plugin from After Effects. They have 3D like simulations on gravity and everything. This has been available inside of Fusion in 2010.
Hi there, my name is Boże Floch, and this is Equals Fuge.
And I've been trying to figure out how to do this for literal ages. Yet there was a script made. I think this guy's on like Windows XP. This guy made a script already for it in 2010. And it says you can get the script in the comp here. When you click the link, nothing happens anymore. That really breaks my heart. Let's go to the next one. Another thing is the RenderMan plugin for DaVinci Resolve Fusion. I found this about 1 year ago, and I kind of sat on it and thought that it would kind of update and develop in some way. And I also sent out an email if I could be a beta tester for this, but I've had zero response. This is a completely new renderer inside of DaVinci Resolve Fusion. And I recently did some tests, tried to like do like ray tracing recently, and like doing simple things like creating a sun inside of Fusion, and it would just glitch and not work. And if you look inside these settings, you have settings of ray depth, sampling, deep rendering, just some crazy stuff. And I'm pretty sure this is like, I don't even know what this stuff is, you know? And we have fabric shaders being put in. Crazy stuff. Crazy comps that I wish that everyone would be able to put their hands on. But no, it's been 2 years and we haven't had a single response from this thread. And I doubt it's going to be coming out anytime soon, but hopefully this video will shed some light on that. A script for Time Remap inside of DaVinci Resolve called the Remap Assist Button Panel. And I searched my butt off trying to find this script, hoping that it would be out somewhere, released, and it's nowhere to be found. This is a script that will help people do time remap and twixing with a click of a button, and literally, I'm pretty sure you're the only one that has it. So, great.
For FPS.
Great. This was recorded in 2024. Posted in 2025, is still no trace of this script anywhere. And I used to be in your Discord server. This was like in 2024. So this is before I got banned, Peej. I scoured your server constantly for like stuff, anything. I would scroll all the way up to the top of the Discoveries channel, and there would be nothing related to this. So hopefully this will see the light of day in the future. The next thing I want to point out is the AI set extender. This YouTuber, John Castillo, has a feature in DaVinci Resolve that nobody else has. And this literally is huge, you know, and I'm pretty sure this is more on DaVinci Resolve, like Blackmagic's end. When he renders it, it's saying generating from server. So I'm not even sure how like final this feature is, but this is the only video proof that we have of this feature being real inside DaVinci Resolve. And nobody has this. As you can see, there's a text prompt box and it will literally generate and extend everything outside of the frame. And it's just like, dang, I wish we could have the Photoshop extender for DaVinci Resolve all the way 8 months ago. There's a completely new transform node with centering controls down on the bottom with the in and out button, which supposedly automatically places the keyframes. This is just a whole new level of gatekeeping. I mean, if I were to make a completely new transform node, I would at least put like a post about it on the DaVinci Resolve forums, or maybe updates on the GitHub telling people that it's coming. But I'm pretty sure everyone's left in the dark about this other than the people that are helping Peej make it. But that's just literal speculation. I have zero clue about this. This isn't a part of his AFX pack, and that's behind a paywall as well. So there's literally no way to get this node, and I'm pretty disappointed about that. That being said, guys, I'm going to be putting 101% of my effort in delivering plugins, macros, and tools that people have not heard about inside of Fusion and inside DaVinci Resolve, so everyone can improve. And honestly, if we want to take over After Effects or really insert DaVinci Resolve further into the conversation, it takes community effort. We all need to be together to really collectively improve. And that's what I want to see in the future for 2026 for DaVinci Resolve. So I just wanted to use my platform and talk about that, because honestly, it makes me pretty sad and a little bit disappointed, because I'm really passionate about this community and I love it. And they're just tools that I'll never be able to use that I would love to use. And yeah, that's it, guys. Love you.